Hello. So tonight I am carving this little bonnet head shark that I had drawn up last week. And I'm going to start with the teeth. Get a little shark teeth in there. I'm starting with the teeth because it's the smallest area on this carving that I need to get into. And if I overshoot one of the areas, which, you know, can happen, I can fix it with the rest of the carving. But not necessary, because I got it. So, got those four little teeth in there. Now I can move with confidence throughout the rest of the carving. I know I've been doing a lot of these live carving sessions the past few days. So hopefully you guys aren't getting tired of them, and maybe it's completely different people seeing them too. The people that are here may not have seen them last time. But hopefully you guys are still enjoying them. Thank you. Find where I put my tools from last time. I'm looking for this one right here, my little Yu-Gi-Oh tool to get this little piece out. Curving around the mouth. So I'm doing the face and the head first, because when I'm in these areas, that is going to be a point of focus, just because it's the head, nothing else. I kind of want to maintain the line work that I originally drew, nearly if not exactly 100%. I don't want the mark making to be distracting from the drawing. So I clear out much of these areas. But as I get further down onto the body, like on the back and stuff, and in the belly, I can take a little bit more liberties and the mark making to make it interesting. Curving. Get a little zigzaggy curve in there. Undercut that. And then up here. Largely clear out that area. Alright, so the boring part is largely done. Clear out and give him the little highlights in his eyes that he so desperately wants. And then I am going to do this little mark here. Okay. So I have got my little bonnet head shark. Face carved out most of the way now. Ooh, I get to do a fun little zigzag in his fin there. I'm gonna have a lot of fun carving out those little bubbles. Okay, get my smaller Yugo to get in and clear this out. And then make this part interesting. Taking out little scratches. I'm gonna leave that just like that. Alright. So now with zigzag fin underside belly time. Carving. Straight line there. Carving like that. Alright, now I'm going to clean this out. The top side zigzag. I'm going to do something interesting, I think. I'm going, you'll see. Clean out the top side of the zigzag. So first line it. And so when I'm carving, I think of the whole carving in areas of black, white, and gray. I don't generally do a whole lot of areas that are straight black. I like my carvings to appear on the lighter side. But sometimes I do, like, I'll dedicate, like, whole, like, this is a black area, the eyes, and I make it a point to myself to not take any of that away. And then this would be a white area where I'm taking it all away. And then I've got the gray areas, like what's going to be the back, and I'm going to do something here where I'm just going to make this a gray area. And I'm going to just take out little nicks. I'm going to do it very organized to make it appear gray. And what I mean by gray is when you print obviously I'm only printing in black and white. Or when I'm inking, it's only in black and white, or black in the color that I paint on top. But you can use tricks that if you take out little parts and then you step back and squint your eyes, it can appear gray. And that's what I'm doing here. You leave little bits of black and little bits of white, and it creates value. So this is going to be one of my gray areas. When I first started carving, I kind of was really I was really big on the idea that you should have like 30% black or 30% white, and then the rest would be either black or gray, just so you could have a strong, otherwise it looks kind of muddy sometimes. And I feel like that's probably pretty true with what I do today. You don't, if you have everything, if you have it 50-50 black areas, white areas, it tends to look a little bit, a little muddy and a little confused. So I try to sway to one side. And with my style and my work, I tend to sway to the white or the color of the paper or whatever I paint it side. And I'm just kind of talking to myself right now. Not really responding to anything, but that's kind of what I'm thinking about when I'm carving. Now the back that I'm carving right now is another gray area. And currently I'm carving it so it's going to be 50-50. You know, maybe it's like 60-40. But I'm going to come back over the top of it and carve some lines going perpendicular to the lines that I'm carving now. That'll take a little bit more away. So if you hang out for another 15 to 20 minutes, you'll see me make those marks. Maybe not quite that long. It's hard to know how long it takes me to do things sometimes. Before I go any further on the back, I am going to go, it might be a little longer, but I'm going to go and do this belly so I know what to carve up to. I'm going to give myself a line to carve to. Bubbles. I gotta get these little fins on the underside. I should look up to see what those fins are called. I know now these are pectoral, that's dorsal. Are these ventral fins? I think they're ventral fins. So I'm going to call them ventral fins. I'm probably wrong though. One of them might be, but I doubt both of them are. Alright, so I get these bubbles out. And I want these bubbles to look blobby and uncontrolled. So I'm going to use my U-gouge to give it a unique shape. an organicness to it. Smaller you gouge, where are you? I call upon you to help me finish this little tail part or the little belly part. Alright, so I'm gonna clean up this line because it's kind of fuzzy. So I'm just gonna clean that up a little bit. And then I'm gonna come back and underneath this. Let's take out little cuts here, little scratch. I mean, they're a little bit more than scratches, but I'm not going to zigzag. I'm going to keep those just like that is. All right, so I've got the belly done. I'm going to come back to doing these. I'm going to start over here, and I'm going to work my way back to that, so I don't lose my shape. And one of the reasons that I spray paint my blocks before I start carving them is so I can visualize the black and the gray and the white that I was talking about earlier. So you can kind of see the gray happening as I remove the material on the back of this shark. The more I take away, the lighter it gets, so to say. It's not quite as light as this yet, but it's not as dark as this either, so we see the value coming out, and it's easy for me to see. Some relief carvers will opt to tone their surfaces with red, and to me that is perfectly fine. It makes more sense for sometimes for what other artists are trying to achieve, is they want to recreate and create a block as close as possible to the drawing that they've come up with, and by toning their block red, they can, you know, give themselves a simple rule to remove all the red and leave only the black that has been drawn. And then it's easy to go about doing, well, not easy, it's time consuming and very difficult actually. But the red will highlight to them what still needs to be removed. But me, I like to use the mark making to my advantage. And so that's why I choose to tone my blocks black. So you can kind of step back and squint your eyes and make adjustments as you carve, as you see. Is this MDF? Yes, this is MDF. Indeed it is. Most of the things that I carve are carved out of MDF. Not all the things. Sometimes I use linoleum or other materials. But most of the things I carve are MDF. Including this piece. Does it dull my blades quickly? I mean, I don't know. It's all I carve so quickly is a relative term. And to me, you know, I have to keep my blades sharp, but it's not a chore to do so. I have a sharpening system. And I sharpen it as needed. Once every like two or three carvings or so. And I use a slip strop that I have on the desk with me that I will use throughout a carving if needed to keep my blades working just like they were at the beginning of the carving. But I mean, I don't feel like I spend a lot of time sharpening my tools. You need sharp tools for anything you do, and any material will break them down. I know MDF does it a little quicker than other surfaces, but okay. So remember when I was talking about doing the perpendicular marks to the marks that I've already made in the back? That's where I'm going right now. So first I'm going to just do a top edge mark. Just carve out the top edge there. And this gives me like a little bit of a dot pattern going on that I think quite nicely mimics the sandpaper texture of a shark's skin. And it also just gives it a little bit more of that organic feel rather than being so mechanical. Oh yeah, that's pretty good. I'm looking at it in the screen too. The screen helps me visualize things. Alright, so I'm gonna come back up and do this pictorial thin. Alright, so I want to start changing the direction of my mark making a little bit. Not much though, just to kind of wrap around a little bit further, angle it slightly different. So I'm intentionally doing that as I get to the bottom of this pictorial fin. Towards that tip, it's gonna get cleared out mostly. up this back edge here with some those tiny little Nikki carve marks. So it's not just a flat. I like to avoid, you know, clear demarcations and in the lines that I've made. So I like breaking up when I can. When it makes sense, like I wouldn't do that there. I want a clean line there, but there's some areas where I don't necessarily want a clean line. And that line that I just made being one of them. So, okay. All right, moving on to the pectoral fin, or the dorsal fin. I think it gets carved largely the same way. The same thing. I'm gonna add the perpendicular marks to kind of give it more value and more interest in that area. And then I curve the back edge of this fin nicely. But I'm not gonna do it in a straight line. I like to avoid those when I can, like I said. I might even go like a second layer of little nicks. Just break this up, this black area a little bit more. I don't know why I decided to do that, but I haven't done that on any shark fins in the past. But it just struck me to do it here. So why not? Alright, so last but not least now, I will be working on the tail fin. Have my carving skills ever gotten me a date? I've been on I went on a couple of dates with girls that I met through my work. So yes, probably. I mean, I don't think it was the only aspect. I like to think that partially it was because of my personality too, but I don't think there's much of a, a groupie mentality for relief carvers. What kind of wood do I use? I carve MDF. Medium density fiberboard. you didn't get to see the Bramble live. Yay, yeah, I'm glad you were able to catch this one. I think so. I think I like the teeth too. See, look. Aw, little teeth. I like the teeth on them. I don't think he would be much of a shark without his little teeth. This is something I gotta look up. I don't even know if sharks are probably born with teeth. I can't imagine them born without teeth. I guess it probably depends on the shark too. I never even thought of that before. I don't think alligators are born with teeth. I think. I can't remember seeing a baby alligator without teeth. But I haven't really seen many baby sharks. I've seen like zebra shark pups. Seems like every aquarium has those because they're unique. Because they have those nice stripes when they're young. Just have to do like a competing mark instead of a going with the flow mark on this one. I think it worked out quite nicely. A competing, and by that I mean a mark that goes, this mark's going like that. Typically I would carve with that line, but this time I went against the line. So I competed with it. To do a back edge mark now, because when it comes towards the point it becomes on the top, and then the front edge, so to say, is on the bottom. And I'm going to do the same thing. So, well, no, I'm not going to compete with this one. I am going to do little marks. I'm not going to be super concerned with connecting them. Pretty much it. So I've got this bramble shark here now. I'm looking on the screen. See, it's a little dark up here. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this away. Not too much, because it is behind the hammer or the bonnet. I kind of like it. I'm going to get rid of part of this line. I'm going to take away part of that just so it doesn't look so strong. Looking on the screen, see what I like, see what I don't like. I kind of like the rest. Hello, hello. You're just popping in, you're just catching the end of this. I'm about to finish up here with the carving of this little bonnet head shark. So, but here's what I got. He just kind of swims in and away. Yeah, I think he's done. I think he's done. Cool. Yeah, I like this area. This is one of the harder transition areas to do. I am going to be very discerning on this one. I'm going to do this a little bit. And then I'm going to bring this out a little bit more. And then I'm going to taper these lines so they're not as clunky. That's a little bit nicer. Yeah. All right. Done. I'm not going to mess with it anymore. It is what it is. And it is finished. So I got this little bonnet head shark, and he is done. So thanks everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed the process. So thank you. I will be signing off now.